My name is Robin Pijnakker, and this is where we design and manufacture our cabin fire and smoke trainers. Everything is being designed and manufactured in-house. We deliver our cabin fire and smoke trainers to training centers and airlines all over the world. Let me show you our latest model. This is the V9000 Commander XR. XR stands for Extreme Reality. Let us have a look inside. This is the observation area of a next generation fire trainer. And what we see is that it is a nice spacious room with an excellent view on the fire training area. Well, what makes a next generation fire trainer different from previous generation fire trainers? Well, a number of things. And one of the things is that the fire training area is in an enclosed cabin environment. That means that the trainee really gets the feeling that he is in a real aircraft cabin. Also, due to the setup, whereby we have a galley in the front, we have seat rows with overhead luggage bins, we have a lavatory in the rear, which makes that it is a realistic cabin setup. Another aspect is that the width of the aisle is the same as in a real aircraft cabin. That means that you are really close to the fires. In a next generation fire trainer, we try to simulate the circumstances of a real aircraft cabin fire. And how do we do that? We do that by triggering all your senses. And that means that you really smell something burning, you really see flames and you feel the heat. You really can feel the heat on the luggage bins, on the lavatory door. You have smoke that obstructs your visual. And you even have cabin sound, panic sound, to make the circumstances come as close to a real cabin fire incident. Let us have a look inside. The observation area is separated from the fire training area by a sliding door. In a next generation fire trainer, sensors are monitoring your extinguishing performance. And the fire trainer is equipped with automatic fires. And what does it mean? Automatic fires means that if I select a fire on the instructor station, the fire goes on automatically. But if I extinguish the fire correctly, the fire also switches off automatically. I will demonstrate that to you. I select laptop on the instructor station. And what you see is that I have fire, smoke, and a glowing spot. I will extinguish the fire. And what you see, there is still a glowing spot remaining. I have to cool down the glowing spot. Because if I'm not cooling down the glowing spot, the fire will automatically relight. Automatic fires means that I can see the result of my extinguishing action on the instructor station. There's a green button here stating well done. That means that I have extinguished the fire correctly and that I've cooled down the glowing spot properly. The benefit of automatic fires is that every trainee is presented the same program and every trainee is measured by the same criteria. If we have this result of my extinguishing action here, it's also automatically locked. And the log file of my training can be exported to any kind of learning management system. That's about automatic fires. I show you something about lithium-ion battery fires. Next generation fire trainers are especially designed to train for lithium-ion battery fires because fires in PEDs, personal electronic devices, are the number one fire threat in today's cabin. So what can you train in this next generation fire trainer? Well, first of all, you can train a lithium ion battery fire in a smartphone, whereby you, for example, put the smartphone on the seat as if it was cracked in between the seats. You can also simulate a tablet fire and you put it, for example, in the overhead compartment. And you simulate as if the tablet is going into a thermal runaway during the flight. And you can simulate a laptop fire, which is, for example, positioned on the tray table. The nice things about these lithium ion battery fire scenarios is that you can train the entire procedure from A to Z, which means that you start with extinguishing the fire, cooling down the glowing spot, but you can also take away the PED and put it in any kind of containment bag that you have on board. Which means that if you are carrying any type of containment bag on board of your aircraft, you can also train for using it inside this next generation fire trainer. The fire trainer also has the possibility for air conditioning smoke. I will demonstrate it. The fire trainer is equipped with a high-speed extinguisher refilling system. It's very easy. We hang the bottle in the refilling station. A green light starts flashing, and as soon as the green light turns to steady, the fire extinguisher is refilled. It only takes 17 seconds, and it's not necessary that the bottle is completely empty. During the refilling station process, the fire extinguisher is locked, and now it's available for action. In this next generation fire trainer, a lot of parameters are configurable. What does it mean? That means that the total training time is a setting and can be configured. The difficulty level can be changed. You can change the difficulty from level 1 up to level 5. The amount of smoke per location is configurable. You can either program only a very little amount of smoke or a huge amount of smoke. Light settings are programmable. You can switch on burning smell. You can switch on or off cabin sound. So a lot of parameters are configurable. And it also means that you can program up to 8 different training programs in the fire trainer. That means you can program different scenarios for initial training and different scenarios for recurrent training. I show you how that works. We select a training program, and for example, we have here programmed 4 initial programs, and you can make distinctions in an initial program. For example, you can make a daytime flight, you can make a nighttime flight, you can have a training program with a small incident with very little smoke, but you can also program a scenario whereby it's nighttime, whereby there's a lot of smoke, there's a very heavy fire, there's panic sound, etc. You can also choose to make recurrent programs based on your experiences on the line, so you can simulate actual incidents. I show you one very easy scenario, and I show you a very hard scenario. Let me select initial A. In this scenario, we have a cabin fire, we have smoke, we have a glowing spot, we have difficulty level number 1. It's bright, the lightning is bright, there's only very limited smoke, and this fire must be pretty easy to extinguish. I can also select initial program D. You see the light is dimmed, that means we have an evening flight. I select a laptop scenario, and what we have a lot of smoke, We have an intense fire. We have panic sound, etc. A next generation fire trainer gives you so much possibilities to custom the training to your specific experiences and needs. This next generation fire trainer is definitely one of the most sophisticated fire trainers currently available in the world. Many airlines and training centers are already using our equipment to their full satisfaction. We look forward to getting in touch with you.